had some people that walked in and walked out of her life, but she made it because she has the right one. And so if you want anybody to stay, it's not a man, it's not a woman, it's not an organization. You need God to stay in your life. How many know you need God to stay in your life? I got a song on this record that she really has made big. Let me just hear just a little bit of it.
Please do me a favor, give it up for DJ, he's not so good. I'm joking.
Lord, I wanna take this time and thank you for putting up with me, clapping. And I'm sorry you've had to deal with me. I haven't done right, I haven't been pleasing in your sight. But give me some time to make it right. I'll go the extra mile, don't wanna make you frown, just to do it your way. Lord, have your way, I'll do whatever it takes. Say, Lord, I'm begging you to stay. Come on, give me that. Let me do it. Everybody, help me. Say, Lord, I'm begging you to stay. Stay. If you know what, help me sing it. Come on. Lord, I'm begging you to stay. Oh, we. Yeah, said I know that I messed up over 1,000 times. Yeah, but you always forgave me. I'm so glad to call you mine. Now, Father, you've been there through my thick and the thin. Down through the years, Jesus, you've been my only true friend. I call on you, you've seen me through. I'm standing on your word. I'll pray to you all I need you to do. Yeah, yeah. Lord, I'm begging you to stay. Come on, South Carolina, help me do it now. Come on. Say, Lord, I'm begging you to stay. Yeah. Lord, I'm begging you to stay. Yeah. Please don't leave me here. Yeah. To stay. I can't make it without it. And I don't care how much money you got, I don't care who you know and what you know, you can't make it without him either. I heard David say the other day, restore unto me the joy of thy salvation. There are some times when you lose what you have, but you ask God to give it to me one more time. All right, let me do this dependent, because she has, if it was not for Loretta Coleman, believers really wouldn't even be known in this area. She was the first one to bring me to Columbia, South Carolina, and I'm eternally grateful. I've been here ever since. All right. Growing up as a child, come on, hear me. In my mother's care, Mama told me, yeah, he would always be right there. Oh, now I'm a grown man, yeah, yeah, come on. I'm living on my own, and I'm so glad tonight I can truly say, how many can lift your hand and say, Jesus, he ain't never left me alone. Tell them no. Come on, everybody, help me say. Say, I am depending on you. Does anybody here ever tell the Lord that sometimes, Lord, oh, I'm depending. said, get my mother's hair. I never will forget it. Mama told me, yeah. Gina would always be right there. Oh, now I'm a grown man. Y'all wanna help me say, living, 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 living on my own. And I'm so glad today I can truly say, I bet you can help me do it. That Gina's here.
Yeah! we met too. Mommy, how you doing, mommy?
Right before we eat. That's my pastor.
Some of y'all know I joined
That's
the church,
my pastor.
Charles B. Jackson. But my schedule on Sundays puts me at a different church as well. But this is my pastor right here. This is my pastor. As you know, this is Loretta's pastor as well.
Yes.
We are going to have him say a few words. Bless the food. Oh, wait, we still didn't say happy birthday, Sean Jones.
Yeah, we did.
Oh, I missed that. I must have been praising Jesus. Call me a pastor. Mommy.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Good evening. The word for this birthday celebration is loyalty. Say loyalty.
Loyalty.
Reverend Loretta Coleman
sent
me a text saying, Pastor, I know the kind of schedule you have on Tuesday. I've been going since 8:30 this morning nonstop. Included within my day has been the ministry to the family of Ethel Jivers. Let me tell you who Ethel Jivers is. Ethel Jivers and I grew up with one another across the street on Double Branch Road. We were classmates. She has served as the director of our Reverend James B. Adams Senior Citizen Center. Outstanding. If Loretta Coleman isn't in heaven, the rest of us can give it up. Say it again. If Loretta Coleman is not in heaven, the rest of us can give it up. Amen. That's the kind of person that she is. And she passed away, and it was very, very disheartening. And the older you get, the more difficult it becomes to let that stuff roll off. And so it's been very challenging, very painful. And so I've been ministering to that family in addition to a number of other things today. And so she said, very understanding of what my commitment was, Pastor, I know that you love me. Don't try to push yourself to make it by the celebration. But the word for tonight is loyalty.
Loyalty.
All right. Now, let me tell you, that is why the word loyalty has driven me.
Yeah.
Loyalty is becoming, in this modern church era, a word that is both foreign and forgotten.
That's right. Sure is.
That's right.
People are not loyal to you.
That's right.
They are loyal to what they need from you.
That's right.
Now, we do know about what I'm saying here. Once they have gotten from you what they need from you, then they've forgotten what they got from you, and they go on to someone else to meet a different need. When Jesus Christ speaks of loyalty, then a man will come after me, let him deny himself, take the cross, and follow me. And it concerns me, and I've had our people to know, and I've said it repeatedly yet, even in my travels, that everybody who is with you is not for you. Everybody who is with you is not for you. I'm here tonight to say happy birthday to one whom I'm with, and I want her to know that I'm for, and I praise God for the treasure of our love and friendship. Happy birthday.
Thank you. Can I get up?
Take a picture, boss. Get somebody to take a picture. I'll take a picture, boss. Just a few.